Hi, it's Michelle with Inhale Yoga Studio, coming to you today with a couple of techniques for creating strength and support along the back muscles and the spine. So today we're going to look at three poses: Shalabhasana, which is locust pose with some variations on the arms. We're going to look at a moving bridge pose, again with variations on the arms, and then a classic bridge pose to open up the chest and work the arms a little bit more. In all of these poses, we'll be using the muscles along the spine, as well as the glute muscles and the hamstrings and the postural muscles in the upper back. So to begin, if you will please come lay on your belly. As you start this process, you want to be sure that you're not in pain. So if you're already in pain, it's better to talk to a doctor than try to start a yoga program. So as we come onto the belly, we're going to stack the hands on top of each other and let the forehead rest on the hands. And just take a few breaths here so you can start to connect to your breath and get a deeper, fuller breath inside the body. Feel with each inhalation, there's an expansion of the belly, the back, the ribs. And with each exhalation, there's a softening. And just let the attention of your mind focus into that expansion and softening. And then from there, let's bring the arms alongside the body and place the forehead onto the floor. We're going to bring the hands up so that you interlace the fingers, then draw the arm bones into the sockets and stretch down through the knuckles. Try to keep your wrists straight and your palms pressing toward each other. You can always grab a strap to go a little wider if you need a little extra space. Arm bones pull back. Press down into the tops of the feet, lift the belly slightly, and as you inhale, start to press your knuckles back towards your heels. Take care not to look too far ahead. Let your gaze be low so the neck is long and balanced on the front and back. And then as you exhale, let's come down. Turn the head to one side and release the arms and pause. Let the breath become slow and steady again. And then we want to do that again, so bringing the forehead to the center of the mat. Hands come behind you, interlace the fingers, press the palms together, arm bones draw back, and then reach through the knuckles. Press through the feet and draw into the belly, and as you inhale, lift the torso. Manage the neck, and then if you want a little more, we're going to peel the hands up off of the back and reach even closer to the heels. And then as you exhale, let's come down, release the hands, and turn on the opposite ear. And then one more time, we're going to bring the head toward the center, hands interlace on the back, draw the arm bones back and reach through the knuckles. From here, press down into the feet, tone and lift the belly a little, and as you inhale, come up. So it doesn't matter how high you get off the floor, we're just using the muscles of the back to help lift you. Reach through the knuckles, and then if you want more from your hands, lift the hands off the butt. And then as you exhale, come down. We're going to turn on the opposite ear one more time and pause. And then from here, let's bring the hands under the shoulders. Tuck the toes under and lift through the belly. And as you inhale, press through the arms to come up into a tabletop pose. From tabletop, let's just round the spine and let the head drop and stretch the muscles along the back. And then from here, just make your way onto the back. So coming into seated and then lying on your back, soles of the feet are going to come onto the floor, letting the head rest back toward the floor. The arms are going to come down along the side. First, we're going to start with moving bridge. So notice if your shoulders are rolling up. And if they are, let's walk the shoulders under you a little bit so that the arm bones can relax back toward the floor. Try to find a place where your knees feel like they're in line or over top of your ankles. And then we're going to press down into the feet, and as you inhale, lift your hips, lift your arms until they're all the way on the floor above you. Stay there as you exhale and really stabilize. Press through the feet, and as you inhale, maybe lift a little bit higher. And then as you exhale, let's come all the way back down to the floor. We'll do that again. Press into the feet, inhale. Exhale, stay there and stabilize. Inhale, lift maybe a little higher. And then exhale and release, returning to the floor. One last time, press into your feet. Inhale and rise. Stay there, pause and exhale. Firm the glutes, inhale to lift. And then as you exhale, let's come all the way back down. Pause. Let the breath be smooth and steady. And then we're going to combine the first pose with the second pose. So the arms of the first pose with the legs of the second pose to create this full bridge pose. So with the feet on the floor, you're going to press into the feet, draw the arm bones back, and as you inhale, lift your hips. Now we're going to interlace the fingers underneath of you and then start to walk the shoulders underneath of you so that you're more resting on the upper arms. Keep pressing into the feet to lift the hips and then reach down in the pinky finger side of the hands to stretch and open the chest and arms. Take one more breath. And then as you exhale, walk the arms out of the way. Come all the way down and pause for a moment. And then we're going to do that one more time. So you're going to press into your feet, back into your shoulders, into the palms of your hands, and as you inhale, lift your hips. Then interlace the fingers, slight bend at the elbows so that you can make space to walk the arms in, then start to press through the knuckles, reaching knuckles to heels and pinky fingers toward the floor. Press up through the hips. And then as you exhale, walk the shoulders out of the way and come on back down onto the floor, pausing here. We're going to extend the legs out on the floor, bring the big toes to touch each other, then spin the palms up, press the arm bones back and down, anchor the ribs so that you feel the drawstring engage, the belly lengthen, and the shoulders and head relax back, and the legs really active. Just letting the spine fall into its natural curves, letting the muscles relax around those natural curves. And then let's just take the ankles a little wider than the hips, release the legs, wiggle the hips and shoulders around a little bit, and pause for a moment. Let the breath become slow and steady. Feel the beat of your heart. Each of these poses have a little bit of a back bend component. And so as we work into back bends, we create space and energy in the heart. And so as you're resting here, you might feel that the heart's beating a little fast, that the breath is moving a little faster. And so just try to slow your breath, slow your mind, slow your body. A few more seconds of resting here. And then to come out of this, we're going to wiggle the fingers and the toes, a little energy back into the body. Start to walk the feet in towards your hips, and then roll over to one side. Press down into your hands and come all the way back up to seated. And then just take a moment to feel what it feels like to be in your body, the strength of the back of the body helping to hold and support you upward. Thank you for taking the time to join me and to dive into your own body. As always, if you have questions, you're welcome to reach me at the contact information at the end of this video. You can always join me for class at Inhale Yoga Studio. Check out the schedule online at www.inhaleyoga.org. And please feel free to get social with us. I'm on Facebook, Michelle Stobart, or Inhale Yoga Studio, and also on Twitter at yoga_inhale. Thanks again for joining. Have an awesome day.